welcome to match week 8 of the Premier League, where leaders Leicester City put their latest signing Yannick Vestergaard in the starting lineup to face Manchester United. The Red Devils get a flying start. Jadon Sancho's volley hits Kasper Schmeichel, but Bruno Fernandes is the quickest to react and scores. Both teams have an excellent defense, and that shows in the number of shots on goal. Daka is blocked by Luke Shaw and David De Gea denies him. A long ball finds Aaron Wan-Bissaka, but Daniel Amardi is right on time with his tackle to block the shot. Also, Harry Maguire is right on time to out-jump Jamie Vardy. De Gea beats it away, but the Foxes do get what they deserve. Patson Daka spots James Maddison, who is blocked by Fred, but the rebound does find the net. A fine finish from Maddison to uphold Leicester's undefeated status. The Foxes still haven't lost once and keep their 4-point gap on Manchester United. Third place Leeds travel to the south coast to take on Southampton, but the Saints are quite efficient today. Adam Armstrong opens his account after his move from Blackburn, but Leeds equalize via Adam Forshaw, who is utterly unmarked. Good to have him back after an injury. But the Saints have another trick up their sleeve. Chelsea loanee Armando Broja, who helps them to get a first victory 2-1. Liverpool travel to Watford, where Ozan Toufan makes his debut. Cucho Hernandez immediately finds Ismail Assar, and it's 1-0 after 4 minutes. Toufan has a chance to win it, but the Turkish international misses, and Liverpool find a way through the Hornets' defense with 15 minutes left. An easy one for Sadio Mane, but a bad result for the Reds. Joe Willock has been reunited with Newcastle for good and creates the first danger against Tottenham Hotspur, but once more it's Alan Saint-Maximin who gets the winning goal for the Geordies. No Harry Kane for Tottenham and no points in the northeast. Manchester City get a very easy opener via Riyad Mahrez, who spots an open goal in front of him, but visitors Burnley come agonizingly close to a goal and a point. Ederson denies them twice. Chelsea take on Brentford in a West London derby, and it's Mateo Kovacic who is the hero, with one goal and one pre-assist for Kai Havertz. A wonderful finish from the German, and that makes it 2 wins in a row for the Blues, 2-0. Arsenal brought Martin Ødegaard back from Real Madrid, and Aaron Ramsdale is the new goalkeeper, but it's Berend Leno who is in goal against Crystal Palace, and that is a huge mistake. James McArthur scores thanks to a tiny deflection. Zaha is denied, but the corner kick makes it right. Zaha unmarked, and 2-0. Jordan Ayew humiliates Ben White to make it 3-0 at halftime. Unreal. Arsenal pull one back via Emile Smith-Rowe with an assist from Martinelli. And Smith-Rowe himself provides the assist for Nicolas Pepe. 3-2. But it's too late to grab a point, Adam Smith-Rowe. But Guaita cuts him no slack. Brighton only need one move from Enoch Nwebu to win it in Norwich. The 2-0 is an own goal. Easy peasy, canary squeezy. Everton are lucky when Saïd Benrahma hits the woodwork for West Ham, because Olympic gold medalist Richarlison makes it 1-0. But West Ham do what they want, except with Jordan Pickford. An incredible stop denies Mikhail Antonio, but Declan Rice ruins Pickford's clean sheet. However, the England goalie keeps two more attempts out, and so it remains 1-1 at Goodison Park. And finally, the West Midlands hate game between Aston Villa and Wolves. Emi Buendia cannot believe his header goes over the bar, but John McGinn gives the villains a crucial win over their arch enemy. 1-0 for Villa. See you next week. Peace.